Welcome to Northwell Health's 20-Minute Health Talk, where some of the brightest minds in healthcare help us break down the latest news and developments. I'm Rob Hoyle, alongside my co-host Chris Kaczewski, and today our special guest is Dr. Onisis Stefas. He's the Chief Pharmacy Officer for Northwell Health, and we have a vaccine, and healthcare workers are getting it. This is great news in this war against COVID.
Yeah, this is absolutely great news, and thank you so much for having me on the podcast today. I really do appreciate it. Yes, we are extremely excited about having the COVID-19 vaccine. It's amazing that we're going to be able to provide that additional layer of protection, primarily to our healthcare workers and long-term care residents initially, and then ultimately to the general population. This really is a game changer, and this is really a great weapon to fight against this pandemic. So we are very, very excited.
Yeah, a lot of the things that you've been hearing about this, and it's been such a tough time. It's been so difficult. Healthcare workers have seen so much death, so much despair. We hear people talking about this is the hope. This is the light at the end of the tunnel. Do you believe that truly is the light? This is the light. We've seen the light now.
It is going to be a long tunnel. It's going to take a very long time for us to get everybody vaccinated to get back to that point. But this is a great ray of hope.
Absolutely. Yeah. And for that general public, gotta be waiting for some normalcy. I mean, everybody looking at the summer, want to get back to summertime activities. I mean, I just want to go to a concert. Like, is that, you know, doable? Is that realistic to think that way?
As more and more vaccines become available, you'll have more supply out there in the market and the ability of more people to get vaccinated. Once you have that level of herd immunity, then you can get back to some sort of sense of normalcy. And there'll always be a certain percentage of people for clinical purposes or what have you that may not be able to get it. And that's why it's important. If you're able to get the vaccine, you should get the vaccine. Not only will it help yourself, protect yourself and loved ones, but also help your community and humanity as a whole.
So it is safe.
Absolutely. It is safe. mRNA technology looks like that it's the real deal and it works and also helps kind of speed up the process of bringing vaccinations to market.
One of the side effects of this vaccine is that you may have some pain at the injection site. You may feel drowsy. You may feel a little sick or lethargic for a day or two, but that means it's working.
Absolutely. Yep, you got it. So all those things is your body building an immune response. It's your body building those antibodies so it knows how to, you know, fight off the virus when it comes in. The other important thing is all of those things are self-limiting. Right. So it's not thing that you're going to have to go to the doctor or get treated for the most part. And it's much better than the other alternative of actually getting the coronavirus and COVID-19.
But I just wanted to add in there. So mRNA technology does not inject coronavirus inside of you.
That is correct. Not only is it important to get this vaccine, it's important to get all the vaccines recommended to have that preventative care in order to maintain your health and wellness.
Yes. You want to avoid the pandemic after the pandemic. And so the coronavirus vaccine, two doses, I know Pfizer's 21 days apart. I think, Moderna's 28 days. This isn't anything new.
Absolutely. The manufacturers are saying 94.5%, 95% efficacy. The thing to note there, that's 1 week after that booster shot, right? So we don't really have strong data on what is your immunity after the first dose compared to that second dose, but I can tell you that it is considerably less. So it's very important not only to get the first shot, but also to get the second shot. We're hoping that that people will receive that second dose and gain maximum immunity associated with the vaccine.
And even after you have gotten that second dose, especially in the beginning months, right, we're not expecting the majority of Americans to be vaccinated maybe until the summer. But so you get vaccinated, you still should wear your mask, do your hand washing, all those good things.
Absolutely. All of those behavioral changes of wearing the mask, washing your hands, keeping social distance is absolutely paramount, even after you get the vaccine, because there's still a pandemic going on. So it's really important that you continue to do the right thing, not only for yourself, but for your community and your neighbors, and continue to do those types of things. Absolutely.
And Northwell has certainly taken a leadership role in not even just, you know, COVID response, but also now in vaccine delivery. First in the U.S. to immunize a frontline caregiver. What's our plan moving forward?
Yeah, we were very, very excited about that. And the funny thing is when we provided that first vaccination, we didn't even know that we were the first in the nation. We were just so in tune to ensure that the moment we had the vaccine available, we wanted to supply that to our frontline healthcare workers. right? These people have given so much. They've seen so much despair. If we can give them another layer of protection above and beyond that PPE, we thought it was that we needed to do that and that it was very, very important. And we didn't want to waste a second. Anything that we could possibly control to ensure that it would be a smooth administration of the process, that we wouldn't waste any of these precious doses, we put into effect and we invested in, because we understand how important this is.
What can we tell people who might be sitting the fence, you know, whether to get this or not?
So, you know, the important thing to say is that the FDA did approve this. So what I can tell people is that it went through all three phases of the clinical trial. New York State had its own review board, which we had members in Northwell sit on, and we reviewed all of that data. And the people that are taking it are the frontline workers who we need the most, right? So if, you know, who is up on all the knowledge of the science and everything else that's going on, this is the number one weapon to defeat the pandemic, and that we need to take it. And over time, you're going to see more and more people taking it, and you're going to see those results. And I think those results are going to be really positive. And if we have some late adapters that are going to be coming late to the game on it, I say, you know, better late than never.
We always like to wrap up the show on a positive note. So what gives you hope for the future? What gives you optimism?
What gives me optimism for the future is the way everybody's banding together against this pandemic, and to see the human side of people helping each other. And people going above and beyond, essential workers, everyday people, has been tremendous. And I hope that we keep that level of humanity going forward in the future, on top of all the healthcare innovation and efficiencies going on in the workplace.
Awesome. Dr. Onisis Stefas, thank you so much for joining us today on 20 Minute Health Talk. For everybody else who tuned in, thank you so much. Stay safe. Have a great week.